Hi. Yeah, I haven't streamed in a while, but I've got some ideas and I was troubleshooting a lot of audio problems that I've been having lately with the system. And but I think we're sorted, and I think all I want to do today is we're starting a new movement of the Scandinavians piece, and this one is called Fond Farewells. And it deals with a part in Beowulf where they've destroyed Grendel and his mother, and they're coming back and kind of they party all night, and then Beowulf and Hrothgar are saying farewell to each other at the on the beach where their ship is. And just the speech that they give to each other, the promising, the just the bond that they have between the two countries, is really stirring to me. I really love the sort of bond that they created, and because they've been through so much, Hrothgar in the last 12 years, and Beowulf coming along and vanquishing two of their worst problems pretty much within, within a couple days. So, and just the promises and well wishings, just really, it's a beautiful part of the poem. And I just have some rough ideas. I don't want to go the obvious way of kind of trumpet fanfares and stirring strings. I don't need that, but I'm kind of going more, I don't know, kind of primal, I guess. What might be felt deep down instead of heard, but there will be trumpets in it. Having said that, there will be trumpets. So I'm gonna lay down a couple things, just source material to work with later. But now that I've got two condenser mics set up either side of me, and I'm gonna play an instrument that I'm not qualified to play, but I'm qualified to use. And it's a big old wine bottle, and I'll show it to you in a minute. And I may change the pitch of the low note, but that's going to kind of be the fundamental of the piece. And then I'll check out how the tunings are and then see if I can play some kind of echoey trumpets over it. So that's the plan. So here we go. Yeah, okay. So I had to power up these mics. I hope it works.
Check. 1, 2. Okay, so this is, I don't need this anymore. I'm gonna try the wine bottle first. And we've got one over here, and mic over here. They sound different, but that's okay. Hope you can hear me. Had big trouble last time. Here it is, the big bottle. Easier. It's a Dos Copas.
Dos Copas wine bottle. It's very cheap but not bad tasting wine.
And this one's empty. I'm just gonna get a bunch of long takes on this and then see what the signal looks like. Okay. find the center. I'm feeling lightheaded already.
Right, I don't know how much of that outside noise you can hear. There's a lot of motorcycles going on at this time of night. It's 8 p.m. here in Korea. And while the regular noise of construction and drilling going on in our apartment doesn't happen at this hour, the motorcycles are perpetual. I'm not sure, but I think that's an E or an E flat.
Low E
flat, almost a D. I think I might have to raise it just to be in pitch, in tune. We don't need the mics anymore for this. I'm just gonna see how this this recording turned out. Oh, that sounds better already. It's really low, isn't it? I don't mind if I get a little bit of that ghostly air sound. That's okay, some of it, but I've cut most of it out. It's all right. It looks like that motorcycle sound didn't do much too much to the track. That's okay. I think it's not bad. I might be able to amp up those frequencies, but it's a good start. My plan for this track is to, okay, so as the two men are having this conversation, Beowulf is a lot more mature, I think, and his powers of speech kind of, I mean, Hrothgar knew this about him, but I think Hrothgar is, who's the elder king of Denmark, is kind of caught off guard always by he's kind of caught off guard by Beowulf's eloquence. He doesn't expect it from one so young and someone who's so, you know, obviously courageous and, you know, just, you know, like a fighter. And I don't think he's expecting it from a bold, brawny hero for someone to speak so well. And then it builds up. It kind of, Beowulf says some really wonderful things about the bond between them and how there might have been some, you know, bad air in the past, but he will never forget. And that if he needs anything, even after he's done this wonderful thing for Hrothgar, he said he would do it again in a moment. In fact, if you have any trouble with your neighbors, in times of war, I'll be there with 1,000 thanes at my back. And Hrothgar is so moved by this that he says, I can't believe how I'm paraphrasing, how upstanding a human being you are, and you deserve all the glory that you can have. And if you end up being king one day, you will be the best king that your country has ever seen. And that's it's probably the best thing he could have told him. So in this conversation is not long, but it really kind of builds up these layers of friendship. And it is, you know, it's not drunk talk. They may still be drunk, but after the party the previous night. But it is morning, and they did have a chance to sleep off whatever they were partying the previous night in the renewed, cleansed hall of Heorot. And yeah, so they're saying goodbye to each other, and they, you know, it even kind of breaks down in tears at one point when he realizes that he may never see Beowulf again, because he may have to be in his country, you know, becoming king, and which of course he does. That's a great story. Getting back to what I want out of this track is there's a thread of bond that they have throughout this conversation, and it starts off strong and it just keeps getting stronger and stronger. And I want to kind of build up this thread running through the entire piece that becomes more and more powerful. It's got to feel like this feeling of, you know, brotherly love. And, you know, wow, I don't know, if you've ever bonded with someone so much that you just thought, you know, I would do anything for you, and I would do it all again, because I think you're that awesome. This is what's going on here. And I think it's a really humane part in the poem. So I just thought it needs a piece of its own. So this is what I'm going to do for this one. Of course, I'll cut that. But that's my start on that one. So, I may need some time to pick this apart and decide which individual blasts stay and which ones, which ones go and which ones are superimposed upon the other. I may just do another go because I found that later on I could go longer if I didn't blow so much air across the top. If I focused the stream of air, it was getting the nice low tone without so much wind, and I wasn't running out of air. So maybe I'll do this again. I'll do another one. Why not? Oh, hey, McAuffle. So I'm not doing Skyrim today. Doing my regular thing. I hope you're well in Norway. Okay, do another go. All right, I think that's good. I know it doesn't sound like music yet, but I would say it will, but just no guarantee of that either. What does he mean? Well, if I put, I've just started this piece from scratch, so it's just recording source material that I'm going to manipulate and arrange into something that makes more sense later. This is in this first stage, it doesn't sound much like anything. Probably I could have labeled this session ASMR to be more accurate. Okay, this is where I cut that bit. Okay, I think just to keep this stream a little less boring, I think I'm going to actually lay down some trumpet stuff while the room is quiet. Just then, a motorcycle goes by. Okay. I'm going to get warmed up a little bit and just improvise some notes on this. I think I'll use the same effects. And I'll leave in the dodgy bits, and just get rid of them later. There's plenty of time for that. Okay, this takes a while to set up, but I think we're almost ready. And that was my wife sneezing through the door in the other room. Now, I might mention that if it's out of tune or raspy or anything, I might want that. I don't know if I want completely clean, clear stuff. That's not me making excuses for my terrible technique. It is, but. Okay, that was just tests.
One more time.
Just clip away the bit that goes crack, and then it'll sound fine in the enormous reverb I've got going. Could you hear that? Okay, let's listen back, and I'll put these mics back. Pretty one. These will undergo extensive editing. Clip out the bad stuff. Accentuate the positive. Eliminate the negative. That's nice. That would be me in the studio. I got this. Don't cut. I can keep going. See, it will work. Just cut off the nasty bit. Get rid of that whole one. Okay, what do we got?
Thank you.
if you're following along for the beginning of this, that three note, if you put them together in a chord, it's the first three notes of the Grendel theme from the first movement. So I don't know if that'll work, but I thought I'd try it. Because the hardship that you share is baked into your friendship, into your relationship that you forge with people. If you go through a really tough thing together, you've always got that. And it could be a terrible thing to have to suffer through, but man, does it make for a strong glue in friendships, relationships? It's just the stuff that, you know, if you go through hell together, then you've got powerful friend. And that's what I feel in that exchange between Beowulf and Hrothgar when they're about to part ways before Beowulf becomes king. It's really a great, I didn't really notice that part of the, I kind of glanced over that part because when I was younger, when I read it, because it wasn't, you know, when I read it the first time, I was mostly interested in the kind of the action bits with the fighting the dragon and, you know, Grendel, and I wasn't too interested in the, you know, telling tales at the Mead Hall and all that. But now I totally get it now. I see why, you know, that character resolution, and, you know, has to be there. Every time I read it, I feel something new from it, and it's just amazing. Beowulf. It's so hard to do at low volume. If I had to do that in an orchestral or performance situation, I'd be scared. I'd be shaking in my boots to do that sixth with a mute at a quiet volume. Yeah. Okay, that is enough to start with. That is a good start. So I save. And that is where we shall part ways. It's been an hour, so thank you, whomever. Misan and McGoffle, thanks for dropping by, and we'll catch you next time. Thank you.